Okay, so by the same show of hands, how many have ever heard a tambourine solo, or a triangle solo, or a castanet? Okay, there's a few people. Well, I'm not going to do it as solo today. The rep really isn't out there. But what I would like to discuss is some of the challenges and some of the musical decisions that I make in the orchestra. And so what I thought I would do is play some excerpts from tambourine, triangle, and castanets that frequently show up in the orchestral repertoire, and just talk a little bit about what I decide as a percussionist, how I approach each one. So the first instrument I'd like to focus on is the tambourine. And a very brief history of this instrument. Most Western composers heard this from Eastern Europe. So it typically gets associated with music of Eastern Europe, gypsy music, etc. So like I'll be playing later on with Petrushka, it's in the gypsy dance. I'll be playing the Bohemian dance with bizet. Again, it's sort of associated always with these gypsies and this folk music. The first thing that I'm going to play for you is from Tchaikovsky's Nutcracker, and it's the Russian trade pack dance. And one interesting thing is, Tchaikovsky only says in the score tambourine. Well, as you can see up here, I have four different tambourines. And each one makes a very, very different sound.
Thank you.
beautiful little color. The next example I'm going to be performing for you is from Bizet's opera Carmen, the Bohemian Dance. And I actually used a couple different tambourines. The first section is not as thickly orchestrated, it's supported with a lot of the high woodwinds, a lot of the high sounds. So I'm going to use the little tambourine for that, I think the color blends a little bit better. And then later on, once the orchestration becomes a little bit thicker, the action becomes a little bit greater, I'm going to switch to a more aggressive tambourine and a slightly more aggressive style of playing. Thank you. time you'll be performing on tambourine is a tricky little excerpt from Stravinsky's Petrushka. He asked the performer to do thumb rolls and shake rolls in a very short span of time, and he also has these type of accents, which are called marcata. For the radio audience, I'm holding up an upward pointing arrow. And what that means is that it needs to be a forceful accent. It's not enough just to have an accent. Something like that isn't nearly enough. So what I'm going to use is my knee to really give me some pop. And again, this is from the dance of the Gypsy Girls, tambourine associated with the Gypsy Music. This does not sound